Hello, welcome to the lecture series on automobile engineering. In this session, let us discuss about another wheel alignment angle, toe. In the last session, we discussed about camber angle. Now, we will talk about toe. Basically, what is toe? If you observe the vehicle tires from the top, let us look at these front wheels. These are the wheels, and you are looking from the top. The distance between the front of the tires will not be the same as the distance in the rear of the wheels. The difference in these distances is what we call it as toe. So you can define toe as is the difference in distance between the front and the rear of the tires. You know, we have rear wheel driven vehicles. Also, we have front wheel driven vehicles. In the rear wheel driven vehicles, in the static setting will be toe in, means the distance at the front of the wheels is shorter than the distance between the tires at the rear. This is what we call it as a toe in condition. This distance is shorter than this distance. We call it as a toe in condition. We provide toe in settings. When the vehicle starts running, now, due to various forces that act on the tire, make the tire diverge like that, and they will remain parallel while running. If in the initial setting itself, if they were parallel while running, they will start diverging like this. Then it will be very difficult to drive the or steer the vehicle. So this is what we call it as toe in. In a front wheel driven vehicle, you can see the distance at the front of the wheels is longer than at the rear of the wheels. This is what we call it as a toe out conditions. It happens in the front wheel drive vehicles. If the static setting is toe out while running, you have drive shafts here. They pull the vehicle. So these driving shafts will be pulling these wheels inside like this. Then the wheels become straight. So that's what in front wheel drive, we will have a toe out setting. So now, whatever I explain, once again I have written out there. You can read these statements on your own. So also this, okay? Right. So one more thing, toe will always also will be set on or rear wheels. By chance, you have more toe on one wheel, less toe on another wheel. While driving, they get adjusted and they get distributed and they will have equal toe. Then there will not be problem at all. Either these will create any pull on the vehicle or will not be responsible for the wear of the tire. However, in the rear wheels, the toe setting is not proper. It will lead to wear of the tire. And also, it will lead to pull of the vehicle. So, steering will become difficult. Okay? Note that. So, you will have toe on the rear wheels, on the front wheels as well as in the rear wheels. Toe will be just a few millimeters as I mentioned. So, here you can see the difference between C and D can be 2 plus or minus 2 millimeter like this. 0.08 plus or minus 0.08 inch like that. Very small difference you can find out. Can we adjust the toe? Yes. You can see here the steering rod, if you look at steering link. So, in the steering link, you can see this clamps and bolts. We can loosen and adjust the value. Not a problem at all. We can always adjust the toe. So, let us discuss another very important geometry, wheel alignment geometry, that is steering axis inclination, or you can call it as SAI. I have just taken the cut section of the tire here. Okay, from the front you see, this is the center line, center vertical line, okay, through which the weight acts. Then this is, suppose I have given a slight positive camber, means then that is going to be a camber line, then this is going to be a camber. Okay. As I mentioned earlier, it is your steering knuckle. Steering knuckle. Okay, right. This is, you can see now, I steer the vehicle. Correct. Here you can see there is control arm, upper control arm pivot, here lower control arm pivot. You take this point and this point center and draw an imaginary line. Correct. It will touch the ground here. This radius I call it as pivot radius, or I call it as scrub radius. Okay, steering axis inclination, I call it as scrub radius. This is steering axis inclination. You draw the imaginary line. This is what you call it as upper control arm of the suspension. This is lower control arm of the suspension. Now, when I connect a steering rod and if I steer it, correct, about this axis, it will be steering. The wheel will be steering about this axis. Right? Please remember, this is the tire I am talking about. This is the axis I am talking about. And when I steer this wheel about this axis, it will be steering. So, this will become the pivot point. About this pivot point, it will be steering. Okay. Now, can we adjust this angle? Definitely. Look here now. Suppose these are the positions, then I'll get this. Suppose I slightly push this pivot towards right and then connect. It might get zero, or further I do, I'll get negative. So this I can call it as positive scrub radius. I can call it as zero scrub radius. This I can call it as negative scrub radius. Positive, zero, negative. Now, very interesting thing you see here. Can we provide zero scrub radius? Means, can we have this steering angle inclination, SAI? Why we should provide this or this? Very interesting part is, suppose your wheel is rolling. Let us say, from the road, there is a resistance. This resistance about this point will create a couple like this. So that will be sensed at the steering wheel. So you can sense the road condition by this way. By chance, if I do like this, even the road resistance will be acting in the same line. It will not create any couple. But this, in this case, again, it will create a couple. So definitely you will get the road feel at the steering wheel. Particularly you are driving this vehicle at the night, and many times you may not be able to see the road. So you will get the road feel. So it is better to provide either a positive scrub radius or negative scrub radius rather than zero scrub radius, and that is what you call it as the steering angle inclination. This will meet below the ground, this will meet above the ground, they are exactly at the ground, and this angle you can call it as steering axis inclination. Sometimes they call it as kingpin inclination also. Okay. Now let us look at again the effect of this on the toe. The effect of scrub radius on steering due to road disturbances. So as I said, I have provided positive scrub radius, positive. The vehicle is, say, rear wheel driven. So the vehicle is rolling like this, moving in the, like this way. So then the road resistance will be acting at the center of the wheel. And this is the pivot point. So what happens is, it will make the wheel toe out like this. Correct? If you provide positive scrub radius in a rear wheel drive vehicle, then it will create toe out condition. That is the reason during setting, static setting, toe in needs to be provided. Okay, that's very important. Now let us look at, by chance you have provided negative scrub radius on the same condition. Negative scrub radius means this point about this point will create a torque, the toe in condition it will provide. In such a situation, you provide toe out. In the initial setting should be toe out. Okay, in a rear wheel driven vehicle. Let us talk about the front wheel driven vehicle. You are given positive scrub radius. This is your traction force. This is wheel resistance. So traction force is higher than the wheel resistance in magnitude wise. So net force will be acting this way, and that will create about this point a toe in condition. That's why providing static, it toe out. Okay. Now by chance, it is a negative scrub radius. You can observe here, this is creating this way, clockwise moment. This will create an anti-clockwise moment and all that. This will lead to this magnitude is larger than this magnitude. It will create a toe out condition. Then we require toe in setting. So these are very important. Okay, so it is necessary, either we should provide a positive scrub radius or negative scrub radius to get the road feel at the steering wheel. Another very interesting point you can see. what is the effect of the scrub radius during braking. Assume I have braked this vehicle. It's a rear wheel driven vehicle. Let us say I have braked this vehicle. This is the braking force. Correct? Now the question is, if by chance these are not equal, the force that is applied on a right wheel may not be equal to the left wheel. Then what happens? This force about this point is creating a couple. This force about this point is creating a couple. This is a clockwise couple. This is a counterclockwise couple. Clockwise couple is greater than counterclockwise couple. So what happens? The vehicle steer out like this. So negative scrub radius, it will steer out in the other direction. This danger is also there. Now by chance, if I have a split braking or something like that, diagonal split braking, you see here. So what is going to happen? By chance, it is going to create a couple counterclockwise direction couple, and because of the braking force, this is the reaction that will create a clockwise couple. If you have diagonally split brake and you are having what? Negative scrub radius you have. Because about this is the effort, about this point it is turning. Negative scrub radius, diagonal split if you have, it will try to maintain the vehicle straight even during braking. So that way the vehicle will be more safe. Okay? So hope you have understood how exactly the scrub radius two are related, and the effect of positive scrub radius as well as negative scrub radius. So when to provide toe in and when to provide toe out settings in your vehicles, you must have been clear to you by now. So now another very important thing is the importance of scrub radius to get the road feel at the steering wheel. Also, how exactly it can make the vehicle stable in a diagonally split brake. Also, you must have understood. Another very important thing is, as you have seen, this is the vertical line. Fine. Then this is what you have from the midpoint of the tire, you have drawn a line. And you know, yesterday we have understood, or in the previous video we have understood, this is what you call it as camber angle. Now this is what you call it as, you see here, from again this vertical line, this is what you have called it as steering axis inclination, SAE I angle. So this put together, I call it as the included angle. This much is SAI. Please have this arrow here. This is SAI and this is camber. Put together, you can call it as included angle. Okay. So these are some of the angles that are very important in wheel alignment. Another very important angle that we have to study is the caster angle. That we study in the next session. Till then, thank you very much.